Let me show you one of the most advanced QR creators that there's available. It's called QR Tiger, and basically it's your one-stop shop for QR codes. Let me show you what I'm talking about right now. QR Tiger is gonna take care of all your QR needs. Now let's get started with the first feature, which is creating a QR for our website link. So we're here in the section where it's URL, and we're gonna add, in this case, my website, and we have two options, static QR or dynamic QR. Dynamic QR is the best option. Basically, if you wanna know more, click on learn more and you can do all of this. So basically it's more dynamic than the ordinary one. Let me create a static QR code to just make something quick, generate QR code, and it's gonna generate it for us. So as of now, we have a QR code that is working. Let me show you with my phone camera. Here we go, let's go ahead and click my camera, go to my link, and boom, we're on my website. So just like that, I am able to use the QR code. Now, I can go ahead and download it as a PNG, which is transparent, or the SVG. This is really great if you want to use it on a website. I go ahead and download it and save as a template. Now, basically right now, it's a basic QR code, but there's a lot of things that we can do with QR Tiger. One is, obviously, we can change the patterns. Now, what I like about changing patterns is that it makes it more interesting. So instead of having an ordinary QR code like you see everywhere, this is gonna make it even nicer. So it's gonna be like someone's gonna look at it and say, whoa, that's a really strange QR code. And they'll wanna scan it because it looks unique. So I'll select this one just for testing purposes. And this is the first thing we're gonna edit. So this is pattern. We're gonna go with the eyes, which is the corners on the left, and I can make them circle with a square in the center, circle, circle, and there we go. We can just go ahead and change these. And I'll go with a really weird one, really strange one. And we can also add a logo. So I can upload a logo or remove it, or I can select from the ones that are available here. So I'll select the YouTube logo and it adds it in the center. Or this one looks really nice. I think this is catchy. There we go. Let's go with the colors. We don't want to go with solid blue. Maybe we want to go with a lighter blue that's a little bit more vibrant. Here we go. We can select gradients also. Custom eye color. Obviously, that gradient doesn't go with this. I'll select something like purple. So there we go. Purple to blue, a little bit more. Looks better. There we go. The gradient type, if it goes from the edge or from the center. The background, we can keep it white or transparent background. There's also the frame for this. So you can add like this, like scan me. Like I said, this makes it interesting. Scan me there. Different type of scan me features available there. Solid color, gradients. Again, we can change the colors for the scan me. If you want to change the gradient, that's also possible. There we go. And again, that color really doesn't go with this. So we'll change it to blue. And that looks a little bit weird. Let's keep it solid, okay? And again, we changed the text here. For example, it doesn't have to be scan me. It could be something else. And there's also the font that we can change, okay? And there's also templates. If I save this as a template, I can use it later on for a different QR code that I'm generating. So in this case, I'm not gonna save it because I really didn't work much on this. So I'll keep it as it is. So just like that, let me scan it one more time for you guys. Go ahead and check it out. Here we go, scan. And boom, it takes me to the website. Even if it looks that unique, it works, which is pretty cool. Now that's for the URL. There's also the B card option here on QR Tiger. And we can fill out our details here, which I'll do it right now. So let me do that. Okay, so I just finished filling this out really quickly, and you can see I have my own B card right now with my name, my image, my phone, email, website, etc. If I scroll down, I got my social media accounts that I can add really quickly. I can add my primary photo. I can change this to look something more like gradient, so it looks a little bit more modern. Again, let's choose kind of like that. It looks a little bit more modern. And we have options to generate the dynamic QR code. So let me go ahead and generate it. There we go. So we have a brand new QR code. And again, we can go through the customization to make it our own. Now imagine this, I'm at an expo, I am showing off my products, my services, etc. And I just have that QR code so they can scan and boom, they got all my details that they are gonna need to contact me with a B card, all thanks to QR Tiger. Okay, so that's for the B card. There's also a file system. So I go to, I'll go to file and I'll switch to new category. And here we go, I can upload a file here and I have the option for 5, 10, and 20 megabytes, depending on the plan that I'm on. So if I'm on regular, on advanced, and premium, I go ahead and upload it. And these are the supported formats. And again, With this uploaded file, I just scan it and boom, I'm ready to download it. Again, really easy, and it's a great way to offer your service. So if you're in an exposition and you're offering some type of software, a free demo account for software, well, they just scan it and go ahead and download it really quickly. So it's really useful. And again, we can go through all the customization of the QR code. For social media, we have this system, which is pretty cool. And again, we can add social media buttons here, and we can go ahead and customize each one of these with our link. So like us on Facebook, we can change that to like our fan page, etc. For his YouTube, you can ask him to subscribe, and we can go ahead and add the link here and change the colors for these. By default, it's using the colors, obviously, that the platform identifies with, but we can customize it if we like. Now, there's also the option to change the primary photo. Right now, it's QR Tiger, but again, we can add our company logo, our face, etc., or just no logo if you decide to do that. Header text, description text, the background color. Again, I like gradients, so I could change it to gradient. I like that option. The theme, for example, I can go ahead and change this. And they have different type of views. I think this one looks nice. It's a little bit less clunky than the other one, but it's up to you how you want to use it. Popular widgets, embed a video, meta tags, store hours. There's also the embed other if we want to embed a URL through here. That's pretty cool. And again, once we generate it, we go ahead and customize the QR code. For menu, this is a really great option for restaurants. When the pandemic hit, everyone's using QR codes. So giving us the option for this, we upload the menu and we can use it through there, or we can create a menu through Tiger. It's a different service from QR Tiger, but it's pretty cool that they have Menu Tiger. We can use it alongside with this. The H5 editor. So if you want to use this, enter HTML and generate QR code based on the HTML. That is possible. There's also a lot of options here like style, bold, italic, etc. Everything that you need right here. And then generate the QR code for it. A Google form, if we have the Google Doc form here. Again, we add the link and it generates a QR code specifically for that Google form. Multi-URL, this is a really great option. I haven't seen this in other QR codes. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but I like it because, for example, via location, in this case, I selected this type of QR code, multiple. So let's just say that I want to send someone to sassmaster.net based on the country. So if they are in Albania, which region doesn't matter, city doesn't matter, if they're in the country of Albania, they're going to go to my other side, which is sasm.co, okay? And again, I can add another one from a different country. So if they're visiting from my country, Mexico, we'll send them to whatever MX, okay? This is an example. So QR Tiger is going to take care of sending users to different sections depending on how it's selected. Now there's the options for location, number of scans. So if they scanned it twice, then on the third one, jump to a different link. Or 100 times, maybe you have a promotion, a giveaway, or something like that. And you can say after 100, well, it's over. So you can send them to a different link when they scan this 100 times, or the time, the language, and the geofencing. So all these options are available, and use the same QR code for this. And QR Tiger is going to take care of redirecting these clients, users, fans, etc. to the different type of links, depending on how you set it. So to the App Store. In the App Store, you can set your iOS and Android. And automatically, if they're scanning from an Android, it's going to go to Android app. If it's going to be an iOS, it's going to go to the App Store. There's the Wi-Fi. This is a really useful one, especially at restaurants where you have a lot of flow of people. You can select via WPA, web, or no encryption. And if you select WPA, fill these out. People scan the QR code, and it's going to automatically give them access to the Wi-Fi. So they don't have to ask for passwords. You don't have to type in anything. Just by scanning the QR code, you have access to Wi-Fi. MP3 file uploaded. Facebook, again, via link. YouTube, Instagram, Pinterest, via email. There you go. Set your email, subject, etc. And again, create a QR code for that. Via text, if you have a phrase or something like that you want to create in the QR code, it will do it for you. So let me give you a quick example for this one. If I do this, generate the QR code. And that text is going to be integrated into this QR code. You can see it became more complex. It has a little bit more dots because it has this phrase in the QR code. An SMS, depending, you select the number and the message. An event title, location, start time and end date, create the QR code. And via location. If you want to do a location for a QR code, that is possible. If this is the little point I want to do here for Tannersville, well, I can generate a QR code and it's going to take them to that section because it's going to use the longitude and the longitude for that. And once you've created all your QR codes, we're able to go to my account and edit these or view the past ones that we've created. So let's go into my account, go into dashboard, and in dashboard, we have all the QR codes that we've created, the URLs, V cards, file, etc., the stats for these. So if I go, for example, to B card, I'm able to go ahead and view it, edit it if I need. So I can go ahead and view the note folder, the QR code. I can go ahead and grab the QR code again. I can go ahead and edit this one. I can view the stats for it. In this case, I haven't used it, but you're going to be able to view all the stats available here, like total scans, unique scans, top locations, top devices, edit, download, and download CSV for all this information. So a lot goes into QR Tiger that gives you all the flexibility to create QR codes, make them look nice, view the stats, and modify them later on if we need. So like I said, it's a one-stop shop for QR code creation. So go ahead, go check out QR Tiger in the link in the description, and that's a wrap.